Friday Night Heights on the plains of Auburn, Alabama. It's a quad meet at Neville Arena. Fisk, Talladega, Temple, and the home team, Gabby McLaughlin and the Auburn Tigers. And we welcome you on the SEC Network to our coverage of this quad meet. Jeff Shear along with former Auburn gymnast Toy Garcia. And Toy, we have the two HBCUs in college gymnastics competing tonight in this quad meet and a debut tonight for Olivia Greaves of Auburn. A lot to look forward to.
It's a huge night all around, and as usual, the energy here in Neville Arena is just absolutely palpable. In my opinion, it's one of the best places to compete as a college gymnast. Some lineups have changed, some things have shifted around, but the end goal for a lot of these teams has remained exactly the same.
In the SEC, we say it just means more. Tonight, it just means four. A quad meet, six gymnasts per team competing in each event. You count the top five scores, you drop the lowest score. After all four rotations on each apparatus, the team with the highest cumulative score wins, all four teams competing at the same time. It's gonna be chaos, hopefully controlled chaos. The Fisk Bulldogs are here. They had their program record at the last meet in the Tennessee Classic of a 193.4 for Coach Kareem Tarver. Morgan Price, a first team All-American a year ago. Fisk out of Nashville. And the Talladega Tornadoes, Toy. You know that gymnast, Asia Sims Fletcher, the head coach?
That's exactly right. She actually went to University of Alabama, obviously one of Auburn's biggest rivals. This is her inaugural season, January 26th at SEMO. It was a tri meet. They scored a 190. It's the first time they broke a 190 this season.
And the Temple Owls, also coached by a former SEC gymnast, Hillary Steele. They scored 195.9 a couple weeks ago against Towson. Seven gymnasts set eight career highs in that meet, and it was the eighth highest team score in program history. And how about the Auburn Tigers and Jeff Graba's Gladiators?
14th season here for Graba. He was here when I was a gymnast. 49.15 is their beam average this season. It's their strongest event so far. Cassie Stevens won three event titles at Arkansas on January 26th, and she also won the all-around with a 39.475.
Cassie, in her fifth season at Auburn, has been so reliable for these Auburn Tigers. And here it is, Neville Arena. We're getting ready for all four teams competing at the same time. The first regular season quad meet in Neville Arena history. And the vault lineup is where the Auburn Tigers will begin tonight. And you see Anna Hill, Sophia Groth, Sydney Shoemaker, Sarah Hubbard, who was an All-American in this event as a freshman 2 years ago, Olivia Hollingsworth, and the aforementioned Cassie Stevens and her Yurchenko 1.5 anchoring tonight for the Auburn Tigers. So we've got this four box ready to show you. We're going to try to show every routine as it happens. And Toy, I know you're going to keep us squared away at what we're seeing tonight.
It's going to be an absolute busy, chaotic, but fun competition here. Very excited to see some really good gymnastics. Auburn starts on vault. Nationally speaking, it's been their weakest event so far. So really looking for some stuck landings, some 10-0 starts, and we will get underway.
With Anna Hill.
It's a Yurchenko tucked full. Took a side step there. That'll be about a tenth or two, but good strong opening, which is exactly what the Tigers are looking for as the first one up on vault.
Fisk starting out on beam tonight. Temple on bars and Talladega on floor, as you see Sophia Groth next in the lineup on vault for Auburn.
So far, so good on the balance beam. No problems here. That was her double acro connection. It was a front toss, so a back handspring step out. Opening pass on floor, it was a double pike, couldn't make it all the way around. Looks like she had not a great takeoff. Judges on floor looking for height, amplitude on these 180 split leaps.
And that's Jaden Bryant on floor for the Talladega Tornadoes. And here comes Sophia Groth.
Your can't go full for Sophia Groth. That is not a 10-0 start, that's a 9.95 start, and she did take a step back. That'll be at least a tenth or two as a deduction. On vault, the judges are looking for height off the vault table, amplitude, and distance. And then, of course, staying in between those two white lines. And Sophia did that just fine. We'll take another look at this dismount. It was a nice piked, and she eased right into that landing.
And you can see number three in the lineup there for the Auburn Tigers is Sydney Shoemaker, the transfer from Brockport in New York.
Nice routine from Temple on bars. Did take that step forward a little bit short of that landing, but solid performance all around. So Yurchenko 1.5. Twisted a little bit too early off the table. You can tell because she did have to take that step to the side, which was over the two white lines. That'll be a pretty hefty deduction there. Like I mentioned before, nationally speaking, vault is Auburn's weakest event right now. So as the season progresses, definitely looking to build off of these scores and settle into lineups and look for the minor things like the stuck landings.
Well, they're still looking for their first 9.8 or above as Hill led off with a 9.7 and Sophia Groth followed with a 9.775. Meantime, opening score on bars for Temple, a 9.75. And that's from Reese DeHaan. So Sarah Hubbard, number four in the vault lineup for the Auburn Tigers, as we mentioned, as a freshman, an All-American in Fort Worth, Texas in 2022. Helping the Auburn Tigers reach the Final Four 2 years ago. A 9.825 for Sydney Shoemaker.
Expecting to see Yurchenko 1.5. And she does it, very nice, solid vault. Still looking for that stuck landing though. Auburn hasn't gotten one yet. Should be a solid score for Hubbard.
So Sarah Hubbard congratulated by her teammates.
So far so good on bars for Temple. A little bit of a leg separation there on that giant pool. Nice connection, giant pool to immediate double back dismount. Sticks that landing. You can see she really fought for that.
And that is Angelina Hogan trying to improve on the first two scores on bars for her team, 9.75 and 9.525, as we go to Beam. And that's the Fisk Bulldogs.
Opening up with her double acro series, backhand swing step out to layout step out, had a little bit of a balance check there. She dropped that left shoulder. Nice connection. Judges are looking for complete 180 split leaps. Anything less than that will be a deduction.
And here comes Olivia Hollingsworth.
Yurchenko 1.5 from Hollingsworth. Took a step to the side. That's because she twisted a little bit too early off the table.
Sarah Hubbard, the previous gymnast, scored a 9.875, the highest score so far for the Auburn Tigers. As we look at the bars there for Temple. Emily Johnson next in the bar lineup for the Owls.
Nice major release there. Good connection. Really nice form from this athlete. Nice execution. Double layout dismount. Over rotated just a little.
And here is Cassie Stevens, the anchor gymnast for the Auburn Tigers.
Yurchenko, 1.5 from Stevens. And so far, the best vault that we've seen from Auburn tonight. Almost got that stuck landing.
Almost, just a tiny hop, and that's what you want from your anchor.
Just a tiny hop, we can see there. And I want to remind our viewers about the new stick rule. You must show control before you present to the judges. So a college salute, a college stick does not exist anymore. It will be deducted.
Olivia Hollingsworth scored a 9.825, so Auburn with 3 9.8s or better, and Stevens will certainly be that as well. Had a little bit of a delay on floor. Where the Talladega Tornadoes are competing. Exhibition routines tonight. And that's Fisk on beam. And Saniya Roseby, one of the standouts for Fisk on beam.
Nice connection there from Roseby. So far, so good. Slow and steady. Wins the race on this event. Only thing left is the leap series and the dismount. A little bit of a balance check there. Nice 180 splits, though.
And Coach Tarver says Saniya is coming into her own as a freshman all-arounder, a leader even in her first season.
Nice dismount there by Cantering Step Out to a layout full. Eases right into that landing with no problem. Solid performance. Take another look at her dismount. It's a backhand spring step out to a layout 1.5. And I want to remind you that's a blind landing, so you can't see the floor before your feet hit the ground. She handled that with no problem.
And Toy Cassie Stevens, the score is in a 9.925 for the anchor gymnast for Auburn on vault. So Auburn goes 49.225 in the first rotation. We watch the floor routine. Kiora Peart-Williams receiving congratulations from her teammates.
Mounting from behind the high bar. Beautiful lines from this athlete. Major release there. It's a reverse hecht, also known as a Tkachev. Gearing up for the dismount, we can tell because her giants are accelerating. It's a full out. Takes a small step forward, lands with her chest down, didn't completely finish that rotation.
Serena Whalen, the anchor for Temple.
Take another look at that dismount. You can see there she didn't complete the rotation entirely, which is why she had to take that step forward and land it with her chest down. But really, really pretty athlete to watch on this event.
She's the anchor on bars for Temple as well. And their coach Hillary Steele said she is a beautiful bar worker who leads by example and a vocal leader close to everyone on the team. And Toy, I wanted to ask you about, Auburn has already finished with its first rotation. We still have several floor gymnasts to go. In a quad meet, there's a considerably larger, longer amount of time where you're waiting in between rotations. How does that affect the gymnasts?
Yeah, that's what we call the quad meet woes. It's fun. There's a lot of gymnastics. It can be very chaotic, but also very exciting at the same time, but definitely takes a lot more mental endurance than it would in a typical dual meet.
And you see another great student crowd here at Neville Arena, including the gymnasties. More on them throughout the night. You can see they're vibing.
Gymnasties have been here when I was a freshman, believe it or not. That was back in 2009, so you do the math.
That's 15 years, Toy.
They have earned their place right there in front of the floor, hyping up the crowd and the gymnasts. Love to see that they have kept the tradition going after all these years. Fisk on beam here. Full turn. Mandatory in every beam routine. Front toss. Looks like that might have needed to be a connection, might have missed that there. She'll have to make it up in the rest of her routine. Let's see if she does it. Another front toss there into immediate back handspring step out. So she did make good. Had a little bit of a balance check there on that back handspring step out. So she will get credit for that connection since she redid it.
Good improvising on her part.
Absolutely. Call it thinking on your toes. They practice that also in the gym.
And a great job of staying on the beam there, Toy.
Gainer full up the side of the beam. Almost gets that set landing. Landed with her chest a little bit down.
Every tenth matters, especially when you're able to stay on the beam here. Like that.
Have to fight. Every tenth matters.
So a great job of keeping it together for Aaliyah Reed Hammond. And back to the floor we go for the Tornadoes.
Floor was always my favorite event to compete as a gymnast. Really able to show a lot of personality, a lot of creativity, and showcase your strong suits. First pass here. Front double full. That's an E-level skill. Took a little bit of a bounce out of that. Had a little bit of more energy than maybe she anticipated.
I love her teammates dancing with her.
That is part of the fun.
Oh, yes.
Having your teammates do the routine with you. And you can see them having fun cheering her up over there on the side. Definitely keeps you going, keeps your energy up. During this minute and a half floor routine, it can be exhausting. Next pass here. Front layout to a front pull. Nicely done, no problems there. And finishes the routine with two passes. Two passes are allowed, no deductions, as long as you meet all the requirements within those two tumbling passes.
Nicely done by Alexa Chewy. And here's what the judges are looking for on beam.
Dance and acro skills. They're looking for things to be crisp, finished, and done well. They're looking for execution. Connections, if you don't meet all your connections, you will get a deduction. And of course, balance, any minor balance checks, wobbling to the side, bending over from the hips, those are also deductions. Looking for the athlete to stay right on top of the beam.
Little delay while the judges check notes, get their scores together, give us a chance to tell you about Temple scoring a 48-5-5 in their first rotation, highlighted by a 9-7-7-5 from Emily Johnson, and a score equal by Sarah Stallings, and a 9-7-5 from the leadoff gymnast for the Owls, Reese DeHaan. Boy, while we do have a second, can you recap what you saw from the Auburn Tigers? They scored 49-225. Stevens anchored with the 9-9-25 and did a pretty good job of building scores throughout the rotation.
Definitely excited to see the build on scores. I do, however, think Auburn is capable of much more than what they showed tonight. They looked a little nervous. I mentioned a couple times the landings. As they ease into the season and as the season progresses, hopefully those will become absolute. Those small deductions really add up toward the end of the season.
Coach Jeff Graba said he's hoping to use the month of February to become predictable, know who's doing what they have defined roles, and who you can count on. And here we go back to Talladega on floor. What are we looking for, Toy, on what makes a quality floor routine? What are the judges checking out?
Judges are looking for difficulty, making sure you have all your connections and all the requirements. Presentation, of course, how you showcase your floor routine, making sure your chin is up and you're presenting to the crowd, your fans, your family, your friends. And then, of course, these landings. Gymnasts are allowed to take a lunge step back. That won't be deducted, but anything more than that will cause a deduction. Love the energy here in these routines. Nice leap series there, showcasing 180 splits.
This is Kristen Johnson for Talladega.
Double pike, nicely done. Looks like she didn't completely trust herself in that landing, so it had a little bit of a shuffle of the feet.
I love the ovation she got from this Neville Arena crowd. They appreciate great gymnastics no matter who's competing, no matter which team, especially an in-state gymnast competing for Talladega in its first season.
Let's check back in on this first pass here. Front through to double tuck. That is her double salto. And then, of course, having a great time. That's a part of it. That is totally a part of the showmanship and the presentation the judges are looking for. Definitely looking for these girls to have a good time.
And this is Morgan Price, the star gymnast for Fisk on the beam.
Did take a fall there. That's 5/10. Important for her to regroup right now and finish her routine as strong as she can. Nice front aerial there to an immediate split jump. Beautiful split jump.
Morgan is a team captain for Fisk, as voted on by her teammates. Five-star gymnast originally committed to Arkansas, then wanted to come to Fisk to make history as an HBCU gymnast.
The only thing left is the dismount. So round off, double full, almost gets that stick. Can definitely see why she's in the anchor position. She is solid on this event.
What a great recovery she made there, Toy, after coming off the beam.
Dismount, round off, double full. Doesn't look pleased about the fall.
The look of determination on her face there. Talladega starting to build a little something on floor. 9-6 was the last score, the highest one yet for the Tornadoes on floor. This is Landon Williams in the number 5 slot.
First pass here. Nice connection, front layout to a front double full. You can see she fell out of it a little bit, didn't completely finish her twist.
Coach Aja Sims-Fletcher said her girls were really excited to be able to compete on this huge stage, and you can see that from these floor routines.
Gearing up for the last pass here. It's a front layout to a front full. So both passes were front twisting skills. Nicely done.
A big finish for Talladega. Landon Williams. And here we go, the anchor on beam for Fisk is Liberty Mora. Morgan Price, the preceding gymnast, scored a 9.325.
Had she not fallen, that would have been a 9.825. Very good score. Nice cheap jump there. Love to see when gymnasts take risks doing that. That's a very hard skill to complete. Gainer full up the side of the beam. Almost gets that set landing. Definitely shows control before she presented.
Liberty Mora, the anchor on beam for Fisk. So 3 of the 4 teams have completed their opening rotation. And as you would expect, floor takes a little bit longer.
Definitely important while these judges are making these decisions in between the floor routines or whichever routines where there might be a delay. Important for these athletes to stay in their bubble, to remain focused. It's very easy to break concentration. But that is one of the many things that they practice at the gym during the week.
And the anchor gymnast for Talladega on floor is Alondra Maldonado. She's in her 5th year. She's a grad transfer from Iowa State, anchors beam and floor. The hashtag that Talladega uses, Toy, BTU, for bigger than us.
And that's just to show that they're doing this for people that might not be able to have had this opportunity. They're not just doing it for themselves, they're doing it for everybody. Bigger than us, BTU.
I like it. They want to show that gymnastics at the collegiate level is for anyone. They want to keep displaying excellence in their sport. Maldonado trying to build on the 2.96s for the 2 previous Talladega gymnasts.
Nice opening pass there. The front layout to front 1.5 twist.
Mm-hmm.
second pass here. Double pike. Lands a little bit squatty on that. Love to see the fans getting involved in the routine, clapping along with the music.
It has to be a treat for the gymnasts. And a big ovation for Maldonado.
Take another look at her first pass, front layout to a front 1.5 twist.
Toy, I wanted to ask you, Auburn has completed its first rotation on vault at least 15 minutes ago now. How do you stay locked in, engaged, and flip the switch and when the delay is that big between rotations?
Well, you can see here, and I've actually been looking at them throughout the rotations, but they are totally staying in their bubble, just looking at one another. They're not even focusing on the other teams. They're staying in their bubble. They're trying to keep their energy levels up, practicing their bar routines in their head, and just focusing on one another.
Auburn with a 49-225, Temple with a 48-550 in their first rotation. Fisk a 47-525. And as we await the Maldonado score, Talladega currently a 46-3. That figures to go up when Alondra's score is calculated. And we have an exhibition on floor as well for Talladega. So great opportunity for the gymnasts that didn't make that top six to still get to compete and have the simulation of competing in a big venue with a lot of folks watching, a lot of eyes on you. And as we look at Fisk, you see their beam scores combining for a 47-525. Talking to Coach Sims Fletcher about the challenge of being your first year in a new program, starting a new program from scratch. Said, hey, you're bringing in a bunch of strangers to work together so fast. 11 freshmen on this team, couple international students, couple senior transfers. They're so new and so young. The challenge has been trying to get that consistency going when every day is different. Asia said sometimes she's a mentor, a coach, a strength coach, helping with academics, and it's all paying off for moments like this. Diamond Cook is the gymnast, and Diamond is cooking on floor right now.
She absolutely is. She is an exhibition on this event, meaning her score does not count toward the team total, but it just gives her a chance to compete in a meet-like environment and just getting her that exposure. It's early on in the season, so she very well might make her way into the lineup later on in the season, and so far it looks like she might be securing a spot in the lineup. She's done really well. Very exciting routine to watch.
And that absolutely can happen. If you wow your coach or the judges during your exhibition, you can find yourself in the lineup next week.
Front layout to a front 1.5 twist. Dancing her way to the end of this floor routine. Powerful. Job well done.
And a big round of applause from the Neville Arena crowd here at Auburn. And you see the celebration from her teammates. Oh, that's wonderful. Talladega ended floor with three consecutive 9-6s to score a 46-3. And that puts them in fourth place through our first rotation. So one rotation in the books. The Auburn Tigers on top. HBCU history makers when we come back. One down, three to go.
You are making history, so always walk with attitude and passion to do your best.
History makers on the plains, Jeff Scheer and Toy Garcia back, and we are checking out Fisk and Talladega, the two HBCUs in their first year and second year. It's year number one for Talladega, year number two for Fisk. How exciting is this for these programs to join college gymnastics?
I mean, these teams are paving the way for black gymnastics. The community, they're an inspiration to these young gymnasts, and it's just really exciting to see as a former black student athlete and myself. It's really, really exciting.
It's fantastic representation, right? It matters. And young gymnasts can see these student athletes and say, hey, maybe that's my future.
Absolutely, yes. And as a young athlete myself, student athlete myself, Dominique Dawes was someone I really looked up to. And she is one of the reasons why I continued in the sport. So it definitely matters.
Absolutely. Well, let's talk about Fisk a little bit. Their coach is Corrine Tarver. She was an NCAA all-around champion at Georgia, and she's been blazing trails for a long, long time. And you see some of their notes right there. They launched their program 2 years ago this month. First meet in program history was out in Las Vegas almost 13 months ago now. And then they won their first home meet in Nashville March 17th, 2023. The Fisk Bulldogs in Nashville, Tennessee, competing in NAIA as an NAIA independent. And how about Talladega from here in the state of Alabama? This is their very first season. First meet in program history was less than a month ago, Toy, and they earned their first victory on January 2026. And that had to be exciting for these gymnasts to get a win in their first season, so in their first month of competing.
Absolutely, it's a small program, but coach wants everyone to know that they have a lot of potential. They want people to see their fight, their passion, their determination, their grit.
And there is Asia Sims Fletcher. Toy, as you said earlier, she was a great gymnast at the University of Alabama, and coach Corrine Tarver, she was Corrine Wright when she was at the University of Georgia. She was the first African-American NCAA all-around champion. And that was in 1989 as a junior at UGA. She tells her gymnast, do you want to make history? That's her sales pitch. She said she's seen great improvement over the last year and his program is on a good trajectory. We're back with our second rotation. Going to the bars with Sally right here. Auburn versus Alabama in the Iron Bowl of Gymnastics. Here's where we stand through one rotation. The Auburn Tigers leading 49-225 to Temple's 48-550. And you've got Talladega and Fisk also in the top four as we go to the uneven bars. And Aria Brush.
Beautiful connection there. She is a stud on this event. Just looking for a stuck landing, double layout. Oh, I don't know, Jeff. I saw a little bit of a movement of the feet, but I think the judges might give her that stick.
I'm gonna call it a college stick. Is that your term you used?
That is the term we use. However,
it no longer exists, right?
Get deductions now.
Well, if it's a deduction, it's a small one. Aria Brush.
Beautiful double layout. Just her feet are glued together. She just eases right into that landing. Whether it was stuck or not, she just handles that with no problem.
Aria was ready to go after that long delay. And here we go on the vault.
Your Tenko full. Oh, and sits down afterwards. I think that might count as a fall because she did not salute beforehand.
And that's Jaden Bryant, the leadoff gymnast for Talladega on vault. And now it's Fisk on floor. And that's Jardin Cromartie.
nice opening pass on floor. Front 1.5 to an immediate split jump. Good connection for her. So ring jump to a split switch side.
9.875, the score for Aria Brush in the leadoff spot, and Olivia Hollingsworth second on bars for Auburn.
Major release there. That is a Jaeger. Nice overshoot, finishing right on top of the bar. Judges are looking for handstands to finish right on top of the bar. Nice dismount, it's a full twisting double back. Takes that small step to the side.
Olivia scored a 9.825 on vault, trying to equal or better that score on bars.
On vault, it was a Yurchenko layout. Took a couple steps back.
That's Jamila Duffus, number two in the lineup after Bryant scored a 9.550 in the first spot. What are we looking for on bars, Toy?
So, of course, judges are looking for handstands that finish right on top of the bar, like I previously mentioned. Looking for major releases. That is a requirement for these athletes. And then, of course, that stuck landing for the dismount.
This is Gabby McLaughlin. Getting ready to go. Take her turn on bars. This will be her first event of the night.
She is a staple for this team on this event. She never misses. Very dependable. Beautiful execution. Excited to see what she scores tonight.
And as skilled as she is on bars, it's beam where she's one of the finest beam workers in the country. We'll see that in our next rotation.
Big major release there. So Shapash to an immediate pack salto. Major connection there, major bonus. Nice handstand. Giant fool to an immediate double back dismount. Doesn't quite get that stuck landing. You can see they are trying, Jeff. They are fighting for those landings, but didn't quite get it.
We see another fought for landing on vault there. Olivia Hollingsworth, by the way, scored a 9.8 in the second spot for Auburn on bars. This is Temple on beam. While we wait for the beam lineup, we go to floor.
Wow, nice opening pass. Three connections right in a row there. Front layout to a front pull to an immediate front tuck.
Liberty Mora competing on floor for Fisk. Serena Whalen on beam there in the middle on your left monitor.
Whalen with her double leap series.
Sophia Groth on bars.
Huge major release. That's what everyone is excited for on bars from Groth. And another major release there, that was a pack salto. Good handstand right on top of the bar, gearing up for the dismount. Giant pull into an immediate double tuck, and there is that stuck landing. Bravo.
You can see Sophia knew it. She knew she stuck it, and she's celebrating with her teammates there. A big routine for Sophia Groth. who scored a 9.775 on vault, and something tells me the score on bars will be a good bit higher for Sophia.
Take another look at this stuck dismount. Beautiful giant pull. Ankles just glue together. And I love the excitement on her face when she just nails a routine. It is amazing.
Great job there by Sophia Groth. Saw her mom walking in tonight on the way in, entering Neville Arena. All the way down from Iowa.
Getting another chance here on the vault. Before this, she ran and she stopped right before she got to the table. Front handspring, front tight, big vault. A lot of height off that table.
Well done for the Talladega Tornadoes.
Way to come back. That definitely will get in your head a little bit.
Cassie Stevens awaits her turn on bars for Auburn. Cassie has been rock steady all year long for Auburn, as she was a year ago.
Huge release. Ooh, looks like she peeled off on that just a little bit. Was able to recover nicely though. Nice handstand there. Dismount here, double layout. Sticks that landing, absolutely stuck landing. Shows a lot of control and then presents to the judges. That is exactly the kind of dismount that the judges are looking for. Take another look here. You can see she peeled off just a little bit too soon on that overshoot, but was able to recover just fine.
How big of a deduction might that be, Toy?
She did miss her handstand because she didn't finish the cast into the overshoot, but I would say one to two tenths there. Like I said, she was able to recover nicely, didn't fall, so it shouldn't be terrible.
And a small hop, but a great vault for Talladega.
So far, no major problems for Temple here on beam. This athlete looks very poised and confident. Last thing is the dismount on beam. It's a round off, 1.5. Looks like she might have got that stuck landing.
And this is the moment Auburn gymnastics fans have been waiting for nearly 2 years. Olivia Greaves making her collegiate gymnastics debut for the Auburn Tigers in just a minute.
Graba mentioned that just having her in the lineup will enhance the score by 1 to 2 tenths, which doesn't seem like a lot, but is a huge difference.
A knee injury a year ago, foot injury earlier this year.
Beautiful bar set. Beautiful bar set from that athlete.
That's what the Auburn Tigers have been waiting for. Check out the celebration, and there's her folks in the stands, proud parents.
I know, they're excited to see
Olivia
their daughter.
Olivia Greaves.
Huge major release there to an immediate pack salto. A lot of bonus there. Dismount here, it's a full twisting double back. A little bit of a hop on that landing, but we will take it.
And look at that resume. 2019 U.S. Junior Champion on Uneven Bars that same year. The Junior Championship All-Around Silver Medalist and a member of the 2021 U.S. National Team. And that was her first of many routines for the Auburn Tigers, and a big hug.
She is just overwhelmed with emotions right now. I know the feeling.
A 9.85 from one judge you see behind her. Tears in her eyes. Olivia Greaves has put in so much work. And look at that picture, says it all, Toy.
Parents are so happy. I love to see it. They're so proud of their daughter, and they totally should be.
One of two Greaves on this team, her younger sister, also a member of the team. And Greaves scores a 9.825 after Stevens scored a 9.875. Sophia Groth, the highest score for Auburn, a 9.9. Sophia Greaves is a freshman. Of course, Olivia, a redshirt freshman, as we check out Temple on beam.
Slow and steady here for this Temple athlete. No major problems so far. Front aerial to a meet to another front aerial. Amazing connection there. Don't see that often. A little bit of a balance check there on that full turn. Anything left here is the dismount. So round off. One and a half twist. Looks like she might have got that stuck landing.
Check out Fisk on floor.
Big tumbling here so far for Fisk. A lot of power in these passes from these athletes. Last pass here
for Saniah Roseby.
Wow. Back-to-back double twisting skills. Nicely done.
The Auburn Tigers second rotation as Roseby gets the Queen's crown. Auburn is halfway done tonight. They scored a 49-3 on bars.
Both with the standout 9-9.
And Olivia Greaves a 9.875 in her debut. Same score that Cassie Stevens earned. So Auburn goes 49-3 after going 49-225 on their opening rotation of vault. .98525 puts Auburn on pace for a 197, and there is Olivia Greaves.
Still on cloud nine, it looks.
Judge is convening there. Olivia's been working out in the gym. Jeff Graves said just a few days ago he really would like to get her an exhibition, but she showed him enough to put her in the lineup tonight. Hoping next week will be a normal week for her. They don't want to overload her too early. You mentioned that on bars and on vault, they're expecting just her presence to be worth 1/10 in each of those rotations.
Not only does that help the score, the total team score, but it also pushes the athletes in the lineup to be better. A new person coming in the lineup definitely enhances the competitiveness of these teams.
You can see the smile on her face, knowing the work that she put in to get back from two injuries. And now she's back competing for the Auburn Tigers.
Judges debating there. Oftentimes they'll get together when scores are too far apart. See what one judge might have caught that the other did not.
Highest score on beam so far for Temple is Renee Shugman's 9.7. And we look at the Fisk results there. And again, the smile of Olivia Greaves and her teammate Gabby McLaughlin.
Judges still discussing scoring. Definitely cause a gap in the flow of the competition.
And back to the floor we go.
First pass front through to a double pike. Well, she looked a little shocked there at the ending. The landing there looked like she bounced a little bit. Wasn't anticipating that, I'm sure.
Zaya Coleman.
And Jeff, we touched on this a little bit before, but as a former black gymnast myself, it is just so exciting to see these teams come out and show that an all-black team can do it just as good as anybody else. Promoting, increasing diversity in the gym and having a positive impact on the community.
And this is a great, enthusiastic routine for Coleman from Fisk. Zaya Coleman. Look at that reaction from her teammates.
I think they're happy with that, Jeff.
Yes.
What do you think?
Absolutely. They gave her the crown. Speaking of the crown, that's something that Darion Goburn did for so many years here. And speaking with Coach Corrine Tarver earlier this week, she paid homage to Darion and said, hey, we're glad to be in her house. And she thanked Darion, who last year dedicated her floor routine to Fisk. And Coach Tarver has been to Auburn before, obviously, when she competed. She judged here once as a judge, but previously it had been all the way back in the late 80s when she competed for UGA. And there she is, the former 9-time All-American and the first black NCAA all-around champion at UGA, and a history maker then and a history maker now for Fisk.
Nice triple series there. She did take that fall. That'll be 5 tenths there. Don't see a lot of NCAA gymnasts competing triple series, so super refreshing to see it when it happens. It's very difficult, and when it's done correctly, it is rewarded. Dismount, cartwheel to 1.5 twist. Takes a little bit of a hop forward. Probably not her best routine, but does have the potential to be great there. Take another look at her dismount. Cartwheel to 1.5 twist. Takes that hop forward. That'll be a tenth or two.
Madison Durunda.
Teams are having fun. And that's really what it's all about, Jeff.
And here is Morgan Price, 5-star gymnast.
First pass, huge double pike. She looks very at ease on this event, very confident. Second pass, front layout to a front full twist. That'll count as her double acro. after her little dance break, gearing up for the last pass here. Beautiful 2.5 twist. A lot of difficulty here in this routine. Handles it with no problem. She is a powerful athlete on this event.
Morgan Price, the anchor for Fisk, whose coach said, we are writing history, and I want that history to be a positive thing. She said other HBCUs are in wait-and-see mode, and she said that's why, quote, we couldn't fail. They didn't want to end the movement. They want to this Fisk and then Talladega to be just the first two of many HBCUs to start college gymnastics. And we go back to Beam. And the Temple Owls.
A bit of a balance check there after that front aerial. Looks like she might have missed a connection. Trying again, front aerial.
This is Brooke Donabedian.
Back handspring step out. Side summy, balance check there, couple tenths. Last thing here is the dismount. Round off 1.5. It looks like she might have taken off from the side of the beam there. A little shaky on this event for her.
Again, Shugman the highest score so far for Temple on beam, a 9.7. Morgan Price earned a 9.75 with her floor routine for Fisk. And that's the highest for her team on floor. Exhibitions coming up for Fisk.
Just reminding our viewers that exhibitions will not count toward the team score. It allows these gymnasts to get the opportunity to showcase what they're made of and make their way into a lineup.
Well, I'm already a fan anytime you crank When Doves Cry. Anything from the 80s, really, Toy.
I love it. First pass, double pike. Nicely done, leaned it with her chest just a little bit down.
This is Zanna Brewer in an exhibition routine for Fisk.
Switch side to a popa. Nicely done, 1.5 twist for front pike. Gearing up for the last pass here. Didn't complete that twist, or twisted actually a little bit too much. Had to put her hand down on the ground. So that'll be 5 tenths.
Still a nice round of applause by her teammates and the fans here at Neville Arena. Coach Corrine Tarver said, I want people to see that we can have a team filled with nothing but women of color and be successful. And they are certainly in the process of doing just that in their only their second season of existence. And that's a wrap on our second rotation with the home team Auburn Tigers while we have a beam exhibition. This is Mackenzie Aresta, the exhibition routine.
You'll see a lot of exhibitions earlier on in the season. as teams are still trying to figure out lineups. Lineups usually aren't completely secure until the latter part of the season, going into postseason, conference championships, regionals, and hopefully nationals. Did take a fall there, so of course 5/10 off. Coach Hillary still mentioned Temple had a bit of a rough start. They considered the meets that they've competed so far as warm-up meets. And they're hoping from this point forward to kind of settle in and get in their groove. Back handspring step out to a 1.5 twist, small hop back. Couple tense deduction there.
And that concludes our second rotation from Neville Arena. When we come back, we'll take another look.
Okay, it looks like we need to brush up on your geography, but I hope you enjoy the rest of the meet, and where you go?
Where you go?
Where you go?
Friday Night Heights at Neville Arena. The Auburn Tigers, the home team, in the lead through two rotations. This venue has become one of the most electric in all of college gymnastics. Features an environment that gymnasts around the country love. Here's a look at what makes Neville so special.
There's something about Neville Arena that's different than everywhere else. We give away 1,500 of our best seats for free to our students. Having our students sectioned down, having the gymnastics right front and center on the floor just does something different for the arena.
The energy is amazing in Neville. I think it's because of our students. We have lines out the door before every meet. Those students just always come and bring the energy.
I always love to compete in Auburn just because of how involved the crowd is, the gymnastics obviously. The fans there are just so supportive of gymnastics, so it's fun to compete there.
My favorite venue to compete in away from home is probably Auburn. I know that might shock some people because it is very loud and we have the gymnastics, but I think that it's kind of amazing.
I think Neville Arena is the best place to compete because our fans are not passive fans. They are definitely involved, engaged. They bring the energy every single Friday night, and so it's just unlike any other arena.
Friday Night Heights, and you can see Neville Arena packed with students and fans again tonight. And look, Toy, at how this has grown since 2019 and 2020, when the average was around 6,000, 6,300. Of course, you had the COVID year of 2021. Since then, the last now three seasons, back-to-back sellouts in 22 and 23, and trending that way here in 24.
Jeff, there are three former SEC gymnasts tonight here as head coaches, some of which competed in this very arena, and until this day, they say that it's the best arena that they have competed in. And so they're excited to be back, and the energy is exactly the same as they remember.
Nothing like Neville on a Friday night. When we come back, the Auburn Tigers are on the balance beam. Beam me up, Gabby. Through two rotations, the home team, the Auburn Tigers, sitting pretty with the lead, 98-5-5-0. How about Fisk? Currently in second place, Temple in third, and then Talladega in fourth place in our quad meet through two of our four rotations tonight, Toy.
Really excited to see Fisk and Talladega. They came out and did exactly what they were set to do. Huge gymnastics. Very exciting to see these two teams here tonight.
Temple moves to the floor for its third rotation. Fisk will be on vault. Auburn Tigers on beam, and Talladega on bars in rotation number three. You see Aria Brush, the leadoff gymnast, and Aria told us a couple weeks ago, she said, had there been HBCUs offering gymnastics when she was being recruited, she would have strongly considered them. Well, for Auburn's sake, we're glad she's here, but that just shows you how impactful these HBCU starting gymnastics can be and the opportunities they can create for young gymnasts.
It's definitely history that you want to be a part of. Aria up first on beam. Looking for a hit routine as the leader of the lineup.
Mm-hmm. Aria scored a 9.875 on bars a few minutes ago.
Love how she just moved right out of that full turn. Judges are also looking for the routine to flow. No major breaks between skills. Backhand swing layout step out there, solid, no problems. Leap series. Switch leg leap, straddle, quarter. Only thing left here is the dismount, just looking for a stuck landing. Gainer full off the side of the beam and gets that stuck landing. Stellar performance, exactly what Auburn is looking for as their leader of the lineup.
So important, Toy, is it not, for a flawless or a solid routine to start it off, because then you don't put the pressure on the remaining five gymnasts in the lineup.
And the idea is to build off of those scores. So you want a pretty solid score up first in order to get the absolute highest score toward the end of the lineup.
And no doubt Aria Brush delivered that for her Auburn Tigers. Temple on floor here in rotation number three. That's Summer Ruskey and Madison Durunda. Hannah Stallings, the first three for the Owls.
Mounting from in between the bars. You'll see gymnasts mounting from behind the low bar, from behind the high bar, and in between.
And that's Talladega on bars.
Miss her major release there. That was a Jaeger. She has a certain amount of time to regroup, chalk up again, and get back up on the apparatus. During these moments, she just needs to remain focused, stay in her bubble, and finish strong. Because, of course, this routine could count toward the team's total.
Aria Brush, a 9.85 in the leadoff spot for the Auburn Tigers. And Paige Zancan up next.
Love when athletes show flexibility, strength, whatever they're strongest at on each event. It's really what sets them apart from other athletes.
And this is Paige's third consecutive week to compete on beam for Auburn. Scored a 9.825 and a 9.725 in her first two collegiate meets. She is a freshman.
And as a freshman, she's handling this pressure with no problem. She looks so comfortable up there. No major breaks here in this routine, no major deductions. Twisted just a little early on that dismount.
And you see Paige receiving congratulations from her teammates in the number two spot as we take another look at that dismount.
So 1.5, you can see she twisted just a little bit early, dropped that shoulder. Why she had to take that step to the side.
Ruskey scored a 9.25 in the leadoff floor position for Temple.
Temple's plan tonight was to have fun and to compete free, and that they're doing it for the team. Their main goal is just to be better than last meet, and it's not about a win. They just want to stay in their bubble and be better and build off of last meet.
Hillary Steele, in her first season as their head coach, she previously was an assistant for the Owls. She competed at Georgia. And a big ovation there on vault for Fisk. We go back to bars. The action is nonstop in the quad meet.
So far, no major problems on this routine until that dismount just peeled off a little bit too early. not allowing herself to finish the rotation, which resulted in a 5-10 deduction.
And we go to the beam for Olivia Hollingsworth after Paige Zancan scored a 9.825. Which equals her Auburn high in her freshman season, in her third meet. Olivia, a seasoned vet.
Nice back handspring step out to layout step out. You can see her whispering her key words to herself, so important, something that they also practice in the gym. Staying in her bubble and staying focused. Nationally speaking, beam is Auburn's strongest event so far this season. And we can see why here.
Olivia Hollingsworth. Auburn ranked 10th in the country in beam. There's Olivia again.
Nice double acro series, just right on top of the beam. And her dismount here. We can see why they are ranked 10th nationally on this event.
Go back to Temple on floor. Well, Rusky led off with a 9.25, and then Madison Durunda followed with a 9.7. Hannah Stallings third in that floor lineup for Temple.
Amazing flexibility here on floor. So far, no major problems in this routine.
Into the beam and Sophia Groth. Fresh off a 9.9 on bars.
Acro series, it's a triple. Back handspring step out, layout step out to another back handspring step out.
And the famous Sophia celebration you saw there with a big facial expression. That's what she is known for, one of the many things, the joy that she gives off in competing.
Clean full turn there, showing a lot of control.
Hollingsworth scores in, and it's a 9.875, the highest yet for Auburn.
Dismount here, Gainer full off the side of the beam, finds that landing and just sticks it.
So Auburn 4 for 4 tonight, and Olivia Greaves, the first one there to congratulate Sophia Groth. Hugs all around for the Auburn gymnast. Hollingsworth's 9.875, a season high for Olivia on beam. Zancan, as I mentioned, tied her career best with that 9.825. And Brush led off with a season high 9.85.
Big vault there for Fisk.
That's Morgan Price.
Yurchenko layout full. And that is an error that you do not want to make. You can see that the mat puller, whomever was responsible for pulling the mat, did not pull it out soon enough, and she hit her heels on the mat, stopping any type of momentum into the next skill. That is an error you do not want to make. That is so avoidable.
Here's Cassie Stevens on B. So a tough setback for Talladega on bars.
Talladega just looking to finish up with her dismount, just looking for her to land on her feet. It's a double tuck, and she gets the stuck landing. And what a bummer that is in the middle of her routine, that small blip. But she finished nonetheless.
Great to see her finish strong. Back to Cassie Stevens. We saw her signature move, the Stevens.
Nice stuck landing from Cassie Stevens. Round off 1.5 twists.
Auburn crushing it tonight on beam, as you would expect from a team ranked in the top 10. Sophia Groth scored a 9-9, just like she did on bars. And there's Cassie Stevens.
The infamous Stevens, the skill named after her. And that stuck landing. Well done.
And you see Cassie Stevens, the vault champion a year ago, all SEC on all four events, and the all-around in 2023, and the SEC Scholar Athlete of the Year. She is the complete package in her fifth season from Phoenix, Arizona, here on the Plains.
She is just a stellar student athlete, and I know fans were thrilled to have her back this year.
She's been steady and spectacular from day one this season for Cassie Stevens, really the last two. 9.925 on vault, 9.875, and the floor score, 9.95 from one judge, and a 9.8 from another, so a little bit of a discrepancy there. As we see Fisk on vault. You see the numbers there tonight.
Price with the standing out 9.825.
That was a wonderful routine from Morgan.
A little bit of a struggle there on that pirouette. Didn't get the momentum there. Into her last cast handstand. 1.5 twist, sticks the landing. Little bit of a struggle there, but finishes on her feet and with the stuck landing. Nice double acro series there. Both twisting skills back to back. And this athlete, she is a performer.
Renee Shugman here on floor for Temple.
Nice execution on that double leap series.
As we see Gabby McLaughlin on beam, where she is ranked 16th in the country after Stevens scored a 9.875 with a pretty wide disparity between the two judges. So one obviously saw something the other did not.
Solid performance there from Temple on floor. Powerful tumbling, beautiful 180 leaps.
What do you like about Gabby McLaughlin on beam?
She is just amazing to watch. I mean, I'm totally transfixed when I'm watching this athlete. She has ice water running through her veins. She is the beam queen. Just executes every skill perfectly and definitively. dismount. Getting her off the front of the beam, sticks the landing, and she does what she does best, nails the beam routine.
And that's why Gabby McLaughlin is in the anchor spot for the Auburn Tigers on beam. So beam will be the highest score of the three rotations tonight for Auburn, as the Tigers go 6 for 6 on beam. And again, we mentioned they're ranked in the top 10, number 10 nationally in beam, and a big smile for Gabby. We'll await the judges' scores and have an exhibition for Auburn on beam. .995 from one judge. And it looks like a .99 from the other. So waiting the final score, but that should be a .9925 for Gabby on beam.
Temple gearing up for their last floor routine.
There it is, the beam score for Gabby McLaughlin. And that should give her the event title tonight, pending the final rotation, a 9925, doing what she does so well. Exhibition here for the Auburn Tigers on beam.
Nicely done. Hard skill to do. That will count as her full turn.
This is Hannah Hagel's exhibition routine.
Beautiful side aerial, just moves right on out of the skill.
And that's a tough beam lineup to crack, Toy, for Auburn. It's great to have depth.
Go ahead, Toy. So far, it looks like she really might make her way into lineup. Beautiful athlete on that event.
Auburn goes 49-425 on beam as we go back to the floor. For the anchor gymnast, Brooke Donabedian.
Beautiful opening pass. 1.5 to layout step out. Mesmerizing gymnast on this event.
Her coach says Donabedian is a beautiful gymnast, one of those that you see and remember. Her floor, her dance, her toe pointing are stunning. She is the program record holder on floor. Fun to watch, hard to forget. Leads by example, a perfectionist, and an efficient worker. And we're seeing all of those qualities on display right now.
Last pass here. Front handspring, front double twist. Difficult to do at the end of the routine. Wow.
Brooke,
beautiful gymnast.
Donabedian. Every bit as talented as advertised by her coach. Toy, describe what we're seeing here.
First pass, 1.5 to immediate layout step out. She's a beautiful twister. This athlete is a twister, you can tell. Just by looking at this last pass also, that's an E-level skill. One of the hardest you can do, and she does it at the end of the routine. Very impressive.
Fun to watch, hard to forget indeed. Great finish for Temple. There are the Auburn Tigers beam results to the tune of 49-425. They are heading to floor to close it out in style in Neville Arena, taking a big lead to the last rotation. And we'll look at Talladega's bars results. And an exhibition for Talladega. Great floor exhibition here for Temple. We We talked about the value of these exhibitions to give these gymnasts to provide depth for their team, to give the gymnasts a chance to audition for a lineup spot under game-like conditions, as they say.
And this position is equally as important as being in the lineup.
We await Brooke Donabedian's floor score, which figures to be the highest for the Owls.
And here she goes. Exhibition for Temple.
For Fisk on vault, Roseby's 9.75 and Price's 9.825, the highest two scores. Peart Williams with a 9.725 for Talladega on bars.
Beautiful opening pass, front handspring, front double full. Like her previous teammate, that's an E-level skill, one of the hardest you can do.
Peyton Monk's 9.775, actually the highest score for Temple. Hannah Stallings got a 9.75. Donna Beattie at a 9.725.
Second pass here. Front handspring, 1.5. Jumped out of it just a little bit. Didn't have that control landing she probably would have hoped for. And last pass here. So 1.5 front pike, that'll count as her double salto. Once again, required for every gymnast on floor. Overall, pretty solid performance, minus that middle pass. Showed a little bit of an out of control landing.
And you see the floor results there. We mentioned the high scores. Monk, Stallings, Donabedian also in there with a solid score. And we are through three rotations. Olivia Greaves, not the only Auburn gymnast who has come back from injury. Olivia Hollingsworth knows what that's all about. We'll swag surfing on the plains. We're getting ready for our fourth and final rotation. Auburn in control tonight. Temple currently in second place, followed by Fisk and Talladega. Olivia Hollingsworth for Auburn, competing in her fourth season for the Auburn Tigers. Her time here has featured success as well as challenges. She suffered an Achilles tear her freshman season, grew as a leader on the squad even when she couldn't compete in the all-around. Here's a look at Olivia's road to recovery.
Tearing my Achilles freshman year was definitely a long and challenging process to recovery. The next season I was in Beam, which I was very proud of, but it obviously wasn't where I wanted to be. I wanted to be an all-around. And so that season I learned a lot about myself. I think not comparing yourself to where you used to be, I think in the beginning I did that a lot. I was like, well, last year I was already doing floor routines and this year I'm barely doing a cartwheel. And I think that can just put you in a bad mindset. And so I think taking each step as it comes and seeing where you've progressed from where you were at the beginning of the injury to where you are now, I think is the most helpful thing. I learned how to prioritize other people when they were competing, but I also learned how to prioritize myself and advocate for myself and what I needed. And I had to remind myself, like, you went through something that no one else did, and so you can't really compare where you are to where they are. And so last year, being able to compete in the all-around again, I felt like all of my hard work finally paid off, and I felt like that this is where I was supposed to be.
This is where she's supposed to be indeed. Olivia Hollingsworth getting ready for her floor routine, and you can see, Toy, how her role has increased over these past two seasons as she's recovered from that Achilles injury, coming back to be an all-arounder for the Auburn Tigers.
That's exactly right. These gymnasts have had to adjust with some of the heavy hitters leaving last year. And Jeff Graba said that they're able to compete freer.
We'll see Olivia Hollingsworth. We will see her teammate, Cassie Stevens. Auburn coming to the floor in Oxford. Here's our score through three rotations. The Auburn Tigers in control, 147-950 after that big beam score. Temple, 144-775. Fisk hanging in there at 144-2225. And Talladega in its first season, 141-325. Fourth rotation will feature Temple on vault, Auburn on floor, Fisk on bars, and Talladega on beam. And to lead it off for the Auburn Tigers, on the floor is Aria Brush.
Our fearless leader, Aria Brush, has not let us down so far. Do not expect her to on floor. She is a powerful tumbler alongside some powerful dance.
She scored a 9.875 on bars and a 9.85 on beam.
First pass, front through to double tuck. Huge leaps from Aria. She gets so much height off the floor. She has springs in her legs, it seems. Gearing up for the second pass here. Should be her double acro. It's a double pike. Her double acro was her first pass. Second pass here was her double pike. Second and last pass there. Double pike, finishes very strongly.
Aria Brush leading off for the Auburn Tigers. We had a fall on bar, so we're tending to that gymnast from Fisk. That's always a very concerning sight when you see a gymnast go down and stay down.
Hoping that she's okay.
She's being tended to now by the medical staff from here at Auburn and from Fisk.
See if we can take another look at what happened here. Didn't shift her body over to the right side, or the correct side rather, and just fell on the bar down to the ground. Hopefully she'll be okay. Didn't look like a terrible fall, but you never know what she might have hit on the way down, or even what she might have hit on the ground.
Alyssa Wiggins is the leadoff gymnast there on bars for Fisk.
Hoping that gymnast is okay, of course, but the show must go on. As we look over to floor, Auburn's second gymnast up here
is Hannah Hagel. Training staff is getting a cart ready to safely transport the leadoff gymnast there for Fisk, who is in our prayers.
Just looking to see a little bit of movement from her. hoping that she's okay. And in these situations, it's definitely hard for the fans to focus on other teams, certainly because they're worried about the gymnast on the ground. Nice Rodchenko full from Temple. Took a small step back. Should be a tenth or two off.
You can see personnel there ready to transport Alyssa Wiggins.
Really scary, Jeff, because it doesn't look like she's moved at all. So super important to handle her cautiously. Just reminding our viewers how scary the sport can be at times. These gymnasts make it look so easy, but the sport itself is so very dangerous.
On the floor for Auburn, it is Sophia Groth, who's had a great meet tonight. Nine nines on bars and beam.
Nice E opening pass for her. That was a front double full. Like all of her other events she competes on, she is just a stud on this apparatus. Rarely any major deductions from her. Always know what to expect from her.
I like that wrinkle that she added, the AU that you see at basketball games here at Neville Arena when the Tigers make a free throw.
Nice. One and a half twist. And that'll definitely be a high score for Groth.
As Auburn looks to stack scores, Aria Brush scored a 9.85, and Hannah Hagel bumped it up to a 9.875. And more importantly than any routine going on tonight, we can see the gymnast for Fisk, Alyssa Wiggins, receiving every precaution from the medical staff there that is tending to her.
Can see they're having just a little bit of difficulty shifting her onto the board just because of where she fell. Super important to be cautious right now. And like I mentioned, in situations like this, the team really has to rally together, mentally be strong.
Gabby McLaughlin up next on floor for the Auburn Tigers. Gabby not only a great floor performer, she's also a great choreographer, as she came up with the choreography for more than half of her teammates' routines. She does it all for Auburn.
Beautiful leap series there. She's also another really exciting gymnast to watch on this event. Engages the crowd.
And a round of applause for the Fisk gymnast who is being taken out of Neville Arena to receive further care.
Double pike there, no problem.
Gabby McLaughlin.
Beautifully done.
Auburn has had back-to-back 9.875s from Hagel and Groth after a 9.85 from Brush. And Gabby McLaughlin should be right in that range too after that thrilling floor routine. Now Fisk, Toy, gets ready to regroup on bars, and that's almost an impossible task after you've seen a teammate go down and stay down and have to be helped off the arena. What's the mindset of a gymnast after that as they warm up here?
Jeff, I'm sure they're a little nervous. They're a little shaken up. It's never a good thing to see one of your friends, your teammates, fall like that and have to be taken out in the way that she did. So it's super important to stay in your bubble, regroup, depend on your other teammates to help you get it together, and to really just finish safely at this point.
Great to see them receive some warm-up time here after that extended delay. Meantime, how about Gabby McLaughlin on floor? Toy, a 9.95 for Gabby McLaughlin. And we thought after beam, how does she top it? She got a 9.925 on beam. Oh, here's an encore, 9.95 on floor.
She just never ceases to amaze me. I would love to see a 10.0 from her this season.
Speaking of 10.0 capability, how about Cassie Stevens on floor in the number 5 spot for the Auburn Tigers?
Another gymnast that never ceases to amaze me. I mean, she's in her 5th year of college gymnastics. Such a rigorous task to do, and she's handling it with such ease and grace. It is hard to do what she's doing. Your body goes through so much when you get to a certain age being a gymnast, and like I said, she handles it with no problem. Last pass here for Stevens. It's a double tuck. You can see some athletes have that 4-inch mat on the floor. That is totally acceptable. There's no deduction for that.
Cassie Stevens. Auburn ranks as a team tied for 14th nationally on floor, and you see why.
Big double tuck as her last pass. Hard to do and handles it so easily. Nice stick there for Talladega. And like I mentioned, Jeff, at this point, for Fisk, it's just important that they finish safely, that they don't get out of their head too much, they remember what they practiced, and just do that exactly here, right now.
Says a lot about their mental toughness. For them to get back on the equipment and perform and do what they love to do.
As a young child, my coach back in Maryland, my club coach would always say, gymnastics is 90% mental, 10% physical. Super important to have that mental toughness, especially during a time like this.
They continue to warm up on the bars. Olivia Hollingsworth will anchor on floor for Auburn. And there's Olivia. Cassie Stevens' score still waiting to be posted. Now it's a 9.875 for Cassie.
Beautiful full in opening pass. E-level skill. Back in action on bars. So far, so good from Fisk. Just looking for her to land on her feet on this dismount. A little bit of a quirky landing, but nice start after that terrible injury.
And a nice fall, a nice finish, rather, for Olivia Hollingsworth on floor for Auburn. Sydney Smith, second in the bars lineup for Fisk. That 9.95 for Gabby McLaughlin, a career high. Hannah Hagel's 9.875, that's her first collegiate floor routine as we look at beam. And a nice dismount.
Nice dismount. You can tell she's very excited about that. Good solid routine from Dega.
Alondra Maldonado. And the anchor for Talladega on beam, Morgan Swaby.
Third routine up for Fisk. Nice connection there. Last thing here should be the dismount. Nicely done. Does take that small step forward, but that's the only major deduction. Job well done. Love that this team has regrouped. And they're staying in their bubble and getting the job done.
You see Sarah Hubbard, who's been in the vault lineup for 3 years, with an exhibition routine on floor.
Beautiful twisting skills back to back as a double acro. Definitely expect to see Hubbard in the lineup later this season. Leg vault. She is a powerful athlete on floor.
And Olivia Hollingsworth with a 9-9 in the anchor spot. So Auburn's floor tonight, 49-4-7-5. We check out some beam action with Talladega.
Nice back handspring step out to layout, step out. No problems with that. Front toss. Dismount here, round off 1.5, sticks that landing. Excellent job from Talladega. Way to finish it out.
Big finish on beam. And an exuberant celebration, knocking down a teammate there.
They just could not contain their excitement for her. Beautiful dismount there. Round off 1.5 just sinks right into that landing.
Stuck landing for the Tornadoes, and boom.
And they tornado her down.
Yes. Something tells me Morgan won't mind when she sees her score.
So fall there for Fisk, 5-10 deduction. On her major release, it was a Jaeger.
We asked Jeff Grabe about hosting these two HBCU schools. His quote was, every young female gymnast should have the opportunity to compete in college no matter what. If she wants to, they need to start seeing role models who they can aspire to be. He said it's a huge step forward for HBCUs to be offering gymnastics at the collegiate level. And he wanted Auburn to be a part of that. Said it was important to help them get established and expand their grip on this sport. And that's what is happening tonight. Jeff Grabe and the Auburn Tigers hosting the two HBCUs who compete collegiately in gymnastics, Fisk and Talladega, from right here in the state of Alabama.
Just to go off what you said, Jeff, sports must evolve with the rest of the world. It's important for all identity groups to have support, freedom, and access to participate in any way that they want, not only in gymnastics, but any sport of their choice.
Three Auburn gymnasts competed tonight in all around as we watch this beam routine. Stevens, Hollingsworth, and Groth. And they all scored at least 39.375 or better.
Side aerial, a little bit shaky here in this exhibition. And it's just her opportunity to practice in a meet setting. Finishes with a round off double full dismount.
Grabe and the Auburn Tigers happy with those floor scores. Check out that stacking of the ladder there. McLaughlin with the career high 9.95. Hollingsworth anchors with a 9.9. Stevens, you see her with her coach, 9.875. Same score for Sophia Groth and Hannah Hagel. And Aria Brush led off with a 9.85. There's Gabby McLaughlin. So great job by the Auburn Tigers on floor. So we go back to Bars.
Nice handstand there on that overshoot.
Kiara Richmond.
Gearing up for the dismount here. Double layout. Almost gets that stick.
Almost, so close.
But a beautiful dismount, beautiful double layout. Take another look at this double layout. Nicely done. Almost gets that stick, but just takes that right foot and puts it in front of the other just ever so slightly.
And you see Talladega's beam score. Impressive. Maldonado and Swaby with 9.775s to finish strong for Talladega on beam. And you see our scores through four rotations. Saw Coach Tarver there encourage her team to finish strong here on the bars. Morgan Price is just the gymnast who can deliver a strong anchor routine for Fisk. Sophomore team captain.
Getting the jitters out a little bit, giving herself a little bit of a pep talk. You have to be your own advocate.
While we have a second, we'll run down some Temple vault scores. Shugman and Rusky scored 9.75s, and Bud in the second spot with a 9.8 for Temple. Coach Steele will be happy about those scores. Amelia Bud with the highest score for her team. There they are, take a look at those. And now we're ready for Morgan Price on the uneven bars.
Beautiful opening skill there. Shapaj to an immediate overshoot. Wow, handstand right on top of the bar there.
You can see the Auburn gymnast and every other gymnast applauding for that routine from Morgan Price.
Beautiful dismount there. Full twisting double back. Take another look at this handstand right on top of the bar. That is exactly what the judges are looking for. Moves right on into the dismount. The beautiful full twisting double back. A lot of height, distance from the bar. Again, exactly what the judges are looking for.
We'll take a break. When we come back, we'll wrap it up, go over our final results, and introduce you to our all-around. And we welcome you back to Neville Arena for the first regular season quad meet in the history of this event. Jeff Shear and Toy Garcia to wrap it up tonight. And Toy, we saw some tremendous gymnastics from all four programs tonight. Your takeaways, what did you see from each of these four squads?
Well, I think Temple proved slow and steady wins the race. The two HBCUs, Talladega and Fisk, really did their school a lot of justice here, showing that black girls can do it too, being an inspiration to the youth and the community as a whole. And Auburn finally easing into those lineups and settling in.
And Auburn finished very strong on beam and on floor, and our all-around champion tonight is Cassie Stevens. What did Cassie show you?
She's phenomenal. She did not shock me whatsoever. She did what she's been doing the past 4 years, and she's just a really impressive, not only gymnast, but also a student.
Cassie Stevens winning the all-around tonight. Her trademark move, the Stevens, that we've seen so many times before, leading to a great beam and then finishing on floor with moves like that. And let's check out our Friday Night Heights event winners. It was Cassie Stevens with that 9.925 on vault, Sophia Groth a 9.9 on bars, and how about Gabby McLaughlin-Toy winning beam and floor, 9.925 and a 9.95, and then of course Cassie's 39.550 to win the all-around.
Some super big scores tonight. Like I mentioned, Auburn is just easing into those lineups and settling in. I'm very excited to see what they're going to do for the remainder of the season.
And the big one, some would say the biggest one of the year, next week when the Alabama Crimson Tide comes here. You'll see that on the SEC Network. So it's a clean sweep for Auburn on the event titles tonight. So for Toy Garcia, I am Jeff Shear saying so long from Auburn, where our final score is the victorious Auburn Tigers, 197.425. Join us next Friday at 9 Eastern on SEC Network as the Auburn Tigers take on the Alabama Crimson Tide here at Neville Arena. To watch this meet and others in their entirety, head to the ESPN app. This has been a presentation of ESPN of the Southeastern Conference from our Warrigal Productions crew. Thanks for watching. Good night, everybody.